Ambarkar, Assistant Professor in Computer Science and Engineering Department at Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. Today we are going to discuss a topic on private cloud example, that is an OpenStack. So OpenStack is basically a cloud operating system that controls large pools of compute, storage and networking resources through a particular data centers, and all these managed through a dashboard which gives administrators control while empowering their users to provision resources through a web interfaces. The learning outcome of this topic are, at the end of this session, the students will be able to explain the software architecture of OpenStack. The students will be able to identify the different components of the OpenStack. Now, first we will see what is OpenStack. OpenStack is a collection of open source components to deliver public and private infrastructure as a service, that is an IaaS clouds. It's having a list of components such as Nova, Glance, Keystone, Horizon and Heat. We will see the details later. And this infrastructure as a service cloud allows users to manage virtual machines, virtual networks, storage resources, etc. Now here we will see briefly the history of an OpenStack. In July 2010, Rackspace Hosting and NASA is jointly launched an open source cloud software initiative known as an OpenStack. The mission statement was to produce the ubiquitous open source cloud computing platform that will meet the needs of public and private clouds regardless of size by being simple to implement and massively scalable. Now here in this diagram we will see the architecture of an OpenStack. So this is an OpenStack architecture which is all about providing computing for end users in a remote environment where the actual software runs as a service on a reliable and scalable servers rather than on each end user's computers. The OpenStack is considered as infrastructure as a service. So providing infrastructure means that OpenStack makes it easy for users to quickly add new instance upon which other cloud components can run. So typically the infrastructure then runs as a platform upon which a developer can create software applications that are delivered to the particular end users. Now we will see the list of particular components of an OpenStack. So basically the OpenStack is made up of many different moving parts, and because of its open nature, anyone can add additional components on OpenStack to help it to meet their needs. But the OpenStack community has collaboratively identified key components which are the part of the core of OpenStack. So they are distributed as a part of any OpenStack system and officially maintained by the OpenStack community. So here you can see the components, how they are going to arrange, and according to the particular services they are going to provide. So dashboards are there, identifiers are there, and so on. We will see the details in the next slide of the component. So here are the particular main service and its component we have written. So compute is a main service, Nova is a component, networking is a service, Neutron is a component. Likewise, block storage, identity, image, object storage, dashboard, Orchestrand, these are all are the main services. Then Nova, Neutron, Cinder, Keystone, Glance, Swift, Horizon, Heat, these are the components. So in details we will see in terms of this particular components and services. So first we will see the compute, that is an Nova. Nova is the primary computing engine behind OpenStack. So it is used for deploying, managing large numbers of virtual machines and other instances. Second is a networking, that is Neutron. Neutron provides the networking capability. for OpenStack, and it helps to ensure that each of the components of an OpenStack deployment can communicate with one another quickly and efficiently. Then third one, block storage, Cinder. Cinder is a block storage component. It is more analogous to the traditional notion of a computer being able to access specific locations on a disk drive. This more traditional way of accessing files might be important in scenarios in which data access speed is the most important considerations. Then fourth one is an identity, that is a keystone. Keystone provides identity services for OpenStack. It is essentially a central list of all of the users of the OpenStack cloud, mapped against all of the services provided by the cloud, which they have permission to use. So it provides multiple means of access, meaning developers can easily map their existing user access methods against Keystone. Now we will see the image glance, which provides image service to OpenStack. In this case, images refers to images, that is, means virtual copies are there of hard disk, and glance allows these images to be used as a templates when deploying new virtual machines instances. Next, we will see the object storage, that is in Swift. Swift is a storage system for objects and files. Developers can refer to a unique identifier referring to the file or piece of information and let OpenStack decide where to store this information. This makes scaling easy, as developers don't have the worry about the capacity on a single system behind the software. Now we will see the dashboard, that is an horizon. It is a dashboard behind OpenStack. It is only graphical interface to OpenStack. Developers can access all of the components of OpenStack individually through an API, but the dashboard provides system administrators a look at what is going on in the cloud and to manage it as needed. Then last one is an orchestration. Heat is an orchestration component of OpenStack, which allows developers to store the requirements of a cloud application in a file that defines what resources are necessary for that application. Now we will see the OpenStack compatibility with other cloud APIs. So for an example, the EC2 API project aims to provide compatibility with Amazon EC2, that is an Elastic Compute Cloud. Then GCE API project aims to provide the compatibility with Google Compute Engine. Now pause a video and write it down your answer. State the different challenges of OpenStack. So first is an installation challenges. OpenStack is a suite of projects rather than a single product, because each of the various applications need to be configured, which will suit the user's requirements. Installation is complex and requires a range of complementary skill sets. So OpenStack environment include so many components, and all are make to work together, which is a difficult task, and because it is a still maturing software. Second one is in documentation. Here you will have thousands or hundreds of thousands of virtual machines, and you need to have a well-established, complete automated CI/CD process for software management, which more than 25 projects, managing document quality is always going to be a challenging. Then third one is in upgrading OpenStack. Cloud offers its user not only high reliability but also high availability. So something that cloud supplier will offer in service level agreements, due to its multi-project development approach, the complexity implementation may mean that downtime is an unavoidable consequence. Then the last one is in long-term support. It's quite common for a business to keep using an earlier release of software for some time after it has been upgraded. So even though it is increasing rapidly, still there are a shortage of technical resources who understands the complexity of the OpenStack environment. So these are the challenges. Now here you will see the list of the users of the OpenStack, like AT&T, BCC, Baba Atomic Research Center, BMW, eBay, Ericsson, HP, Coverage Cloud, Intel, NASA, Nokia Networks, Rackspace Cloud, Reliance Jio, Snapdeal, Sony, Volkswagen, Walmart, Wikimedia, Labs and the Yahoo. So we will see the benefits of the OpenStack. Those who chooses to access the source code make any changes or modification they need and freely share these changes back out to the community at large. So it is also means that the OpenStack has the benefit of thousands of developers all over the world working in tandem to development of a strongest, most robust and most secure product that they can. So these are the list of the references which I have referred for this particular topic. Thank you one and all. Thank you.